Hello everyone. So in our previous lecture we discussed about what is bubble sort and we saw its demonstration with an example. So in this lecture we'll see the demonstration of the code using an animation. So here let's say we are given an unsorted array having 5 elements as 5, 1, 9, 2, 10. Now we want to sort this array in ascending order by applying the bubble sort algorithm. So here you can see that this is the bubble sort algorithm. So friends, in our previous lecture we saw the demonstration of the algorithm where we discussed that we start comparing the adjacent elements and if they are in wrong order we simply swap them, and usually when we complete a one particular iteration the largest element tend to sink at the bottom of the array or at the end of the array. And we also discussed that with each iteration we keep the track of the swapping, and if no swap is done in any particular iteration we simply come to know that the array is already sorted. So let's see the demonstration of this algorithm step by step. So here the number of elements are 5 with an index from 0 to 4. So at the first step what we do is we simply create a boolean variable, we give it a name as isSwapped. Now this boolean variable will keep the track of the swapping in each iteration, that whether the swap is done or not. So here you can see at the last step what we simply check, that if the swap is not done then we come to know that the array is already sorted, so we simply break from this algorithm. So we'll see its usage inside this algorithm. So here we have created the boolean variable isSwapped. So friend, here you can see there are two for loops, one is the outer for loop and other is the inner for loop. So usually the outer for loop basically keep the track of each and every iteration, and the inner for loop will simply help us in performing the comparison with the adjacent elements. So let's see the usage of these two for loops. So with the outer for loop we start with I equal to 0, and this for loop will loop till I is less than n minus 1. So here you can see 5 minus 1 which gives 4. So this for loop will travel 4 times. As it is starting from 0, it will go from 0, 1, 2, 3. So with total 4 iterations. So usually this outer for loop what it tracks is, here you can see there are 5 numbers. And we also discussed that with each iteration, the largest element tend to go to its correct position by syncing at the end of the array, and once it syncs to the end of the array we simply don't include that element in the next iteration. So here as the outer for loop will traverse 4 times, with each time we get a number sorted at its correct place. So here there are 5 numbers, so with 4 iterations we will get the 4 numbers sorted correctly at their position. And as the fifth number is only number left, it will be already sorted to its correct position. So therefore we iterate this for loop from 0 to less than n minus 1. So currently value of I is 0 and it is less than 4, which is n minus 1. So the condition in for loop comes out to be true. And as we want to track that whether any swap has been performed with each and every iteration, with this iteration we start with isSwapped as false. And moving ahead, now we encounter the inner for loop which simply compares the adjacent elements and perform the swap. So here you can see the inner for loop starts from j equal to 0. And here it goes till j is less than n minus 1 minus I. Now here you can see that the outer for loop is controlling the inner for loop. Now why we are doing it is because with each iteration, the largest element will sync to the end of the array, and once those elements are syncing to the end of the array, we don't have to include those elements. So as the outer for loop is incrementing one by one, the j will traverse only to those positions which are still unsorted. So let's see it via demonstration. So currently j is less than 5 minus 1 minus 0 because I is 0. So the condition in for loop comes out to be true and for loop executes. And here inside this for loop, we are simply providing an if block where we are simply comparing the adjacent elements j and j plus 1. And as we are sorting this in ascending order, we are simply checking that the value at jth index is greater than value at j plus 1th index or not. So it means we are simply comparing these two elements. Now here you can see 5 is greater than 1. So therefore they are in wrong order. So we simply perform a swap. So here the condition in if block comes out to be true, and here inside the if block we are performing the swap. So usually how we perform a swap is, we create a temporary variable and we store one of the values inside the temporary variable. So here we are storing the value at jth index to the temporary variable, because in the next step we'll override this value and we actually need this value in the later computation. So as we want to swap these two elements, now we are taking the value at j plus 1th index and we are assigning it to the jth index. So it becomes 1. And at the last step, as we have stored this value into the temporary variable 5, we simply assign the temp to the array at the j plus 1th index. So here you can see we have swapped both the numbers using the temporary variable. And then we mark is swapped variable with a value true because we have performed one swap in this iteration. So it becomes true. Moving ahead, now we'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 1. And 1 is less than 5 minus 1 minus 0, which is 4. So the condition in for loop comes out to be true. And here as j is 1, so it will simply point to the first index, and j plus will point to the second index, because now we want to compare these two elements. And here as 5 is less than 9, therefore they are in correct order. So we perform no swap. As the condition in if block comes out to be false, there is no swapping. We'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 2. And 2 is less than 4. So the for loop executes. Now the value of j is 2. Therefore, now we'll compare 9 with 2. So here you can see, as 9 is greater than 2, therefore they are in wrong order. So here we need a swap. So the condition in if block comes out to be true because 9 is greater than 2. So now we'll simply swap using the temporary variable which we saw in our previous steps. So we store 9 in the temporary variable. Then we store 2 at the place of 9. and then we store the value stored in a temporary variable at the third index on the place of 2. So here we have simply performed a swap between these two elements. And we assign value true to its swapped variable, which is already true. We'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 3. And 3 is less than 4. Now we are simply comparing the jth index with j plus 1th index, which is the third index with 4th index. Comparing 9 with 10. So here you can see 9 is less than 10. So therefore no swapping is done and the condition in if block comes out to be false. So we simply skip this part. We'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 4. So now here you can see value of j is 4. And 4 is not less than 4. Therefore, the condition in for loop comes out to be false. And this for loop exits. And just after the for loop, we have completed our one iteration completely. So we simply check that whether in this iteration we performed any swap or not. Because if we haven't performed any swap in this iteration, then the algorithm comes to know that the array is already sorted. But here you can see the value of is swapped is true. So therefore this if condition comes out to be false. So friends, here you can see the outer for loop has performed its one iteration completely with a value of I equal to 0. So after the first iteration of the for loop, you can see the largest element, which is the 10, has basically synced to the end of the array. And here, now you can see 10 being the largest element is at its correct position. So now we'll increment I by 1. And 1 is less than 4. Therefore, the condition in for loop comes out to be true. So friend, now next pass starts. So we simply assign the value false to the is swapped variable. And now the second pass starts. So we start comparing it from the first two elements with j equal to 0. So friend, here you can see the value of I is 1 and value of I is basically controlling the inner for loop. And why it is controlling? Because with the first iteration, we have found our one element which is sorted and it is at its correct position. So therefore, when we are starting our next pass, we don't want to include this element. So our array has now become from 0 to the third index. So therefore, we are subtracting 1 from this condition because value of I is 1. So it means the inner for loop will simply compare these elements from 0, 1, 2, 3 and it will not touch the fourth element using this condition. So currently you can see j is 0 and j is less than 5 minus 1 which is 4 minus 1 which is 3. So 0 is less than 3. And we simply perform the comparison what we did in our previous steps. We compare the value at jth and j plus 1th index. So here as 1 is less than 5. Therefore they are in correct order. So no swap is done. And the condition in if block comes out to be false. Now we'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 1. 1 is less than 3. Now we simply compare the elements at index 1 and 2 because value of j is 1. Here 5 is greater than 2, so therefore they are in wrong order. So we simply perform a swap because condition in if block comes out to be true. So we simply store 5 into the temporary variable. And then we migrate this value, which is stored at the j plus 1th index. We simply assign it to the jth index. So it becomes 2 using this step. And at the last, we simply assign the value stored at the temporary variable to array at j plus 1th index. So it becomes 5. So we have performed a swap here. So as we have performed the swap, we simply assign the value true to its swapped variable. We'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 2. 2 is less than 3. Now we compare the second index with the third index using array of j and array of j plus 1. So 5 is less than 9. Therefore they are in correct order. So no swap is done. We'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 3. Now here you can see 3 is not less than 3. Therefore the condition in for loop comes out to be false and for loop exits. And here we simply check whether is swapped is equal to false or not. But here is swapped is true because we had performed one swap here. So therefore the condition in if block comes out to be false. And friends, here you can see with the completion of the second iteration of the outer for loop, the second largest element, which is 9, is at its correct position, which is the second last position. So here bubble sort makes the largest element tend to sink at the end of the array, the second largest element tend to sink at the second last position, and similarly it goes on like this. So now we'll again execute for loop with I equal to 2 by incrementing the value of I. So I becomes 2. 2 is less than 4. We assign false to its swapped variable. Because with this inner for loop, we are starting our new iteration. So here you can see as these two elements are basically sorted. So we are using the value of I, which is 2, to control the inner for loop in this condition here. So j is starting from 0 and it will go till, which is 5 minus 1, which gives 4, minus 2, which gives 2. So 0 is less than 2. So now we'll again start comparing these two elements. And as 1 is less than 2, therefore they are at correct order. So no swapping is done. And also friend, here you can see the importance of this boolean variable. Because if you see, the array is already sorted. But the algorithm doesn't know this. So here when the j was equal to 0, we didn't perform any swap. And its swapped value remained false. Now we'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 1. 1 is less than 2. So we simply compare the elements at index 1 and 2. So 2 is less than 5. Therefore they are in correct order. So no swapping is done. So this boolean variable still remains false. We'll increment j by 1. So j becomes 2. and here you can see 2 is not less than 2. So therefore this for loop will terminate because the condition in for loop comes out to be false. And friends, here you can see at the last step we are simply comparing that whether is swapped is false or not. So here is swapped value is false, which tells us that array is already sorted and we don't want to continue this algorithm further because we were keeping the track of the swapping. So in this step, the condition in if block comes out to be true and we simply break this for loop. So friends, here we saw the demonstration of the bubble sort algorithm. So in our next lecture, we'll see the demonstration of this algorithm in Eclipse. I hope you like this video. Thanks, have a nice day.